Studying about the transformer, as you can see, I have kept a transformer over here. This is a shell type of transformer, and we are going to study regarding the equivalent circuit of the transformers and voltage regulation of the transformer and how to calculate the efficiency of the transformer. In the previous class, we have seen the equivalent circuit of the transformer, equivalent circuit of transformer. Basically, the equivalent circuit comprises of the losses due to the copper winding. This is the copper winding which you can see over here. Copper winding and your core losses. So the copper winding you represent as your resistance in the primary winding, reactance in the primary winding. So this is your resistance in the primary winding, reactance in the primary winding, and the core losses are reflected as the shunt branch, which is represented by your resistance and your reactance. And you can see similarly your secondary winding is represented by your resistance in the secondary winding and your reactance in the secondary winding. So this is the reactance in the secondary winding and this is the resistance in the primary winding. This is represented, this is your, you can say this is your RC and this is your GC, or you can say this is GC. GC is nothing but conductance 1 by RC, and this is your BM, that is nothing but as 1 by XM. So this is your magnetic inductance, this is also called as susceptance, and this is conductance, and inverse of it is resistance. So this particular equivalent circuit diagram you will be getting. So basically here it is your VP. VP represents your primary voltage. IP is the current in the primary side. Similarly, your VS is the voltage in the secondary side. Your IS is the current in the secondary side. Now, one important ratio, that is your turns ratio, which is governed by VP by VS is equal to IS by IP, and this is equal to your NP by NS, and this turns ratio we can write as A. So now this turns ratio, how do we reflect this turns ratio? How can we reflect this turns ratio? Suppose I write RP. What is my RP? My RP is basically my VP by IP from Ohm's law. Similarly, my RS is equal to VS by IS. So let's see, let's replace this RS by RP. So how do we replace? So from this formula we can say that my VP by VS is equal to A. So if I have to replace this VS in terms of VP, I can cross multiply. I can write VS is equal to VP by A. Okay. Similarly, from this turns ratio, what I can get from here only, what I can write, IS by IP. IS by IP is equal to A. Now I want IS in terms of IP, so I can directly write my IS is equal to A times IP. Now from this ratio we can see that VS by IS, how can I represent VS by IS? Instead of VS I will write VP by A. Instead of IS I will write A times IP. So VP by IP is nothing but as RP. So I can say, and VS and IS is nothing but as RS. So VS by IS is RS. I can say this is RP by A square. So this is my equivalent resistance. Or in other terms, I can say RP is equal to A square times RS. So if I have to refer this term to one side, if I have to refer primary to this side, and I have to keep primary as it is, and I have to replace RS in terms of RP. So I can write my RS as RP by A square, and I can write this term also XP by A square. Similarly, here also this RC would be this RC by A square. Similarly, here XM by A square. So these are the terms which I am going to get.
Or in other terms, if I have to take that aside over there and I have to keep RS as it is, so I will keep this RS and I will keep this X as it is. Instead of that, what I do is that in my RP, how I will represent this RP in terms of RS, I can write A square RS and A square XP. So this was my equivalent circuit diagram, and this terminology is called as referring. Now apart from this referring, now we have to see how do we take the phasor representation of the transformer and how do we calculate the regulation of a transformer. As far as the voltage regulation of the transformer is concerned, why it is an essential quantity and how it has to be taken, we'll be studying. So the voltage regulation of a transformer is a very important concept, and the efficiency of a transformer is related to it. So voltage regulation of a transformer, the second part of it is the voltage regulation. So the voltage regulation of a transformer, if you have to take voltage regulation, what do you mean by voltage regulation? Voltage regulation is also called as figure of merit. Figure of merit, what does it mean, figure of merit? It is the variation of the voltage when we are applying full load to the voltage. Full load means you have a rated ampere. So suppose if you are seeing this transformer over here, it has certain 230 volts, some 8.7 ampere its rated capacity. Suppose this transformer's full load you are achieving, and at no load it will give you 220 volt. And when you are applying a volt load, suddenly there would be a decrease in voltage. It happens usually in your home also. If you are watching a television, and suddenly if you put on a geyser or a heating appliance, you will see to it voltage will dip. So this voltage regulation is basically when full load variation of voltage, when variation of voltage from no load to full load by application of full load voltage. And but when you are applying full load voltage means you are reaching that rated voltage. But when you have to see the variation, when you are doing in a laboratory, what you have to do is that once you have applied the voltage, what happens is that there is a change in voltage regulation, and your no load voltage also changes. So what you have to do is that you have to again bring back that load voltage back into the constant position. So the variation of voltage from no load to full load by application of full load voltage and by making the no load voltage constant by a variac. Now you see constant by a variac. Now voltage regulation would be defined as V no load. No load would be the rated voltage, V full load divided by V rated. This is load. Okay, so basically what is that, at V no load you will get this, can also be represented Vp by A minus Vs divided by Vs. So this is V full load. Okay, so this is your voltage regulation. Now it depends upon the type of load which you are going to connect. Now if you are connecting an inductive load, you will get a positive voltage regulation, more positive voltage regulation. If you are connecting a resistive load, you will get a positive voltage regulation. But as far as the capacitive load is concerned, you can get a negative voltage regulation, and also you can get a zero voltage regulation for a capacitive load. And this zero voltage regulation happens at a leading power factor of 45 degree angles for a capacitive load. It's a very important point in competitive exams. Repeatedly they are asking this. So we will see the phasor diagrams, how you will be able to draw the phasor diagrams, and then efficiency. So phasor diagram, if you have to go, suppose this is your sending end voltage Vs,
and you have a lagging power factor load I. So let this be my IS current. So what is my power factor here? It will go like this. So here you have like this, and this is my IS into R equivalent, and at an angle of 90 degrees from here, I have J times IS X equivalent, and this is my final range of the voltage. So I'll be drawing it. So let it be okay, somewhere here. So this is my VP by A, this is my VS. Now if I have to represent my VP by A in terms of VS, I can write VP by A is equal to VS. VP by A is basically is equal to VS. If I draw over here, suppose like this, I'm drawing another here, I'm cutting at a 90 degree angle. So IS R equivalent, so I can write this IS R equivalent cos theta, and similarly this term can be written as, if this is an angle theta and this is an angle theta, so this term can be written as J IS X equivalent cos theta. So I can write this VP by A in terms of VS plus IS R equivalent cos theta plus J times I X equivalent sin theta. So this is also a particular formula for the voltage regulation, and you can see this is for a lagging power factor load. My voltage regulation here would be VP by A minus VS divided by VS. As you can see, my VP by A is significantly greater than VS, so my voltage regulation would be positive in this case. Now if I am considering a resistive load, in case of a resistive load, my voltage regulation would be as, see, this is my VS, and because I don't have a power factor lag, so my ISRS is like this only, and my ISJ times IX equivalent is like this, and this is my total VP by A. So here you can see this VP by A is significantly reduced. So voltage regulation is VP by A minus VS divided by VS. So you can see the voltage regulation over here is less compared to the inductive load. So this is the case one, is inductive load. Case two is resistive load. Now third load is your capacitive load. So in case of a capacitive load, this was inductive, we will see for the capacitive load. So in capacitive load, your current is leading, so your theta would be like this, and your I times R equivalent would be like this, and this would be at a 90 degree angle. This is at a 90 degree angle, J I X equivalent, and this is your, finally, this is your VP by A, VP by A, and this is your VS. So here you can see this VP by A is getting significantly reduced. So voltage regulation in a capacitive load, VP by A minus VS divided by VS. So it can be, if VP by A is less than VS, it can be negative also. If VP by A is greater than VS, so positive. In case of VP by A is equal to VS, then it is zero. This case is also existing when theta is equal to 45 degree angle, that theta is equal to 45 degree angle. So this was about the phasor diagram regarding the transformer and about the voltage regulation. Now we will wind up with the efficiency, and we'll understand how do we take the efficiency of a transformer. Now to speak about the efficiency of the transformer, the efficiency of the transformer is given as the output by input. As in any machine, the efficiency is given as output by input. So the efficiency, how do you represent your efficiency? If you have tried, it could be output by input. So your output is your KVA plus losses. Okay, so you can write your input. Efficiency is given by how much output you are giving, how much input you are having. So output you are getting KVA, okay. Input is your output plus losses, KVA plus losses.